think you all must be familiar with the word is tsunami, but today I would like to give you some brief information about tsunami. These are the waves generated by earthquake, volcanic eruptions or underwater landslides that can reach 15 meters or more in height, devastating coastal communities. The tsunami danger period can continue for a very long period of time after a major earthquake. Some of the important facts about tsunami are that tsunami can be very, very large. It can range from 10 meters of height to 30 meters. All low-lying coastal areas can be struck by tsunami. Tsunami can move even 50 kilometers per hour, much more faster than a person can run. Tsunamis can occur at any time of day or night. Tsunamis can travel up rivers, streams that leads to the ocean. Now you all must be thinking, what should we do when a tsunami occurs? Now, before the tsunami occurs, find out for your home, school, workplace or other frequently visited local areas are in tsunami hazard prone or not. Practice your evacuation rules. Have disaster supplies in your hand. Discuss tsunami with your family. Develop an emergency plan during the tsunami. If you are at home and hear there is a tsunami warning, then make sure your entire family is aware of it. Take your disaster supply kit. If you feel,
what should be there in the disaster kit?
Some of the important medicines, like the most common injury in it are tree cuts.
Then what type of homes should be there where the tsunami areas are there?
They should not be made up of which will not move when tsunami occurs. And house should be made in high level so that the water does not enter inside the houses. And after the tsunami, you should continue using a radio or television for updates. And you should use your phone calls only for emergencies. Then you should wear long pants and examine walls, floors, doors, staircases and windows. Thank you.